few years ago, the pace of application releases was about 2 to 3 major versions per year, each introducing a set of new features. This translates to several months between major updates, which is a long time in today's competitive environment. This extended duration can be attributed, in part, to a sequential process involving developers and operations teams. In the 4 main stages of deploying a new feature, each stage is managed by a dedicated team, and the sequence of these stages takes time. At each stage, it's necessary to synchronize various actors, coordinate their schedules, plan necessary actions, and so on. This manual coordination consumes a significant amount of time. Continuous integration, or CI, aims to automate operations related to development, while continuous deployment, or CD, focuses on automating deployment operations. Implementing a CI/CD pipeline seeks to eliminate time-consuming manual human activities. The goal is to automate as many steps as possible to take development all the way to production, in order to speed up software development and shorten delivery cycle time tremendously. The desired advantage of a CI/CD pipeline is the ability to deploy new features more frequently, possibly every week or even daily. Let's start with continuous integration. Modern applications are divided into small, independent services, known as microservices. Each developer works on different parts of an application simultaneously. However, when a developer makes changes to an application, these changes can conflict with modifications made at the same time by other developers. First, a source code management, or SCM, helps centralize code changes gradually, managing all evolutions. GitHub and GitLab are examples of highly popular SCMs. It's worth noting that when a developer codes a new feature, they also create the corresponding unit tests. Then, they deposit everything into the SCM. Now, the CI server gets this code. A CI server, or build server, plays a key role in implementing and managing the whole process. An orchestration service like Jenkins triggers a series of actions when it detects changes in the source code. It triggers an automated build and test process. Depending on the programming language, Jenkins calls a service responsible for compilation. For example, Maven is used for compiling Java code. Compilation involves creating a build, which is an executable version of the application derived from the source code and third-party dependencies. These third-party dependencies are typically open-source libraries. Next, the integration server performs a series of quick tests to ensure that the modification doesn't introduce any errors into the source code. Here are some common types of tests, although this list is not exhaustive. First, developer-written tests, including unit tests to validate the proper functioning of a function, and system integration tests to ensure the application works as a whole. In Java, JUnit is popular for these tasks. We also have the quality checks. It verifies that the code quality hasn't deteriorated due to the code changes. SonarQube is a popular service for this purpose. Then, dependency checks to ensure that the third-party dependencies used don't contain known vulnerabilities. Tools like JFrog X-Ray are used for this. If issues are found, the code is sent back to development for bug fixing. However, if the automated tests are successful, the new build is validated and archived in an artifact repository. Examples of artifact repositories are JFrog Artifactory or Docker Image Repositories. Now that the new build is centralized and versioned in the repository, it's ready for deployment. And the entire process is repeated whenever there is a new code or a change in the existing code. In short, continuous integration helps ensure that software components work together. The next step is continuous deployment. The goal is to build software in such a way that it can be released to production at any time. At this stage, new automated tests are conducted with each application delivery on various environments, including production, if the tests pass successfully. Tests are done in an environment similar to the production one to make sure that it will work correctly for end users. For this new set of tests, we have automated acceptance tests using tools like Selenium, which allows complete scenario testing of an application. Then we have tests to assess the entire application ecosystem, including repositories, upstream and downstream applications, etc. Tools like unified functional testing from Micro Focus support this type of testing. But also there is load and performance testing to verify that the new features don't degrade application access and execution times, but also that it can support a defined number of concurrent users. For modern applications, we have deployments via containers, using a Docker image. The advantage of containers is that they guarantee an environment identical to production, from the developer's development machine to the production environment. In short, continuous deployment means that every change that you make goes through the pipeline, and if it passes all the tests, it automatically gets released or deployed into production. Thanks to CI/CD, it is much simpler and faster to develop, test, and deploy a new feature through an automated process. Continuous integration automates activities around development, such as the build, test, and merge process. It allows developers to merge and test their code changes more frequently. This encourages frequent code commits and rapid feedback. Continuous deployment, on the other hand, automates the deployment of an application in a production environment, making it accessible to end users. It ensures software can be released reliably at any time through automated workflows. With this seamless pipeline, multiple releases per day can become a reality. You may have also noticed the importance of testing in this CI/CD pipeline. The principle is to identify an error as early as possible to correct it quickly. Having smaller and more frequent iterations makes them easier to manage. Errors have less impact since they are easier to detect and resolve. With CI/CD, it's easier to release enhancements in small iterations. They become quickly accessible to users, enabling faster feedback and the possibility to adjust upcoming iterations. In conclusion, in today's competitive economic landscape, a rapid time to market is crucial to both meet market demand and obtain user feedback more quickly, thereby improving products and fostering innovation. All of this, of course, ahead of competitors. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you found it informative and insightful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to stay updated on my latest content and upcoming videos. See you in the next one. Until then, take care.